This is a story that Times Now is keeping you ahead on. A day after the center changed the rules of engagement, there are now military-level talks which are underway in Moldo right now on the request of the PLA. Times Now has learned that the Indian side is being led by Lieutenant General Harinder Singh, and he will be focusing on three major issues during the Corps commander-level talks. The focus, however, will be on disengagement in sensitive areas along the line of actual control. Now, to give you a sense of where this meeting is actually taking place, let's see the place Moldo on the big map. Meghna Deka.
Yes, even as we speak, we have military level talks which are currently underway. Here you have it, a graphical representation of where really Moldo is. That's where Lieutenant General Harinder Singh and his team are currently carrying out this meeting. But just to give you an idea, this red line that you see is the LAC. This is the Indian side of the LAC. This is southeastern Ladakh, and this is the Chinese side. Now, this is the Galwan flashpoint, the patrol point 14, this is the spot where, remember, the Indian and the Chinese troops had a scuffle on the 15th of June. And if you come down the straight road, this is the road which has been built by India, the DSDBO. This is a motorable road which is 323 kilometers long. It goes all the way very close to Chushul, which is on India's side of the LAC as well. On the opposite side of Chushul, this is the LAC, and on the opposite side of this is where you have Moldo. This red spot that you can see on your screens, this is Moldo, and this is precisely where Lieutenant General Harinder Singh and his team are there negotiating and speaking to the Chinese about how to go about disengagement. This goes to show the strategic importance of this entire Galwan Valley. This is, of course, the valley that we can see, and you can see the river there as well. This is the Galwan River, which is being marked out on the map. And meanwhile, about 300 odd kilometers away is where you are having the disengagement talks. It's a military level talk, and the significance of this cannot be undermined. It's going to set up the way forward for the major general level talks which are going to happen as well, as to how the standoff is going to be slowly diffused.
Thanks, Meghna, for putting that into perspective. Vivek Narayan also with us. So is Pradeep Datta, our National Affairs Editor, Srinjoy Chaudhary. Vivek, to you first. How do you see the turn of events? Last evening, Times Now reported that the Indian forces have been given a go-ahead by the government. And now the Chinese asking for dialogue once again.
Well, what is happening at the Moldo-Chushul border is extremely significant. The commanders of both the units are speaking with each other. But what is more important is a message which has gone from the government side that you are free to use your firearms if you are acted upon. Well, that's something that every soldier would have wanted. No soldier wants to be there without a firearm or without a weapon. Well, that's something very, very welcome from the government of India's side. But what would be perhaps more welcome is all the chatter that we are hearing from Delhi, the political chatter. If that dies down, it would well empower the soldier much more, because, you know, it is very demeaning and demoralizing for a soldier to hear what is happening. The 20 men who laid down their lives for Bharat Mata, for India, in heavens, in Valhalla, wherever they are, you'll be doing a great disservice by politicizing the entire situation. Meanwhile, here, Leh, where I'm standing, you can see Pranesh right behind me, is an airfield. And from morning onwards, for the past 48 hours, we've been having planes take off and land all throughout. And they're just not doing exercises anymore. This is aggressive maneuvering by Indian Air Force. They are going all around. Remember, Leh is on all four sides, surrounded by the hills, and they are going all around on active patrol duty. And now this is area domination by Indian Air Force. They are telling the Chinese, this is our area, and this is not a defensive posture at all. Anything happens, they are ready to move ahead within or outside the Indian boundaries if it is required of them. If Indian territory has been taken by the Chinese, they are doing it very aggressively along there. And it is also a reassuring factor for the people who are right there on the border, Pranesh. I am at 11,500. Those men are at 14,000 feet above sea level. They need support. They need all the support that we can give from here, whether it be men material or moral support. This is where the third factor of the Chinese Communist Party and government's approach towards India happens. They have started the cyber war on India.
Right.
They have started utilizing Indian intellectuals, Indian people.
We'll come to that. Vivek, let me bring in Srinjoy also. Srinjoy, the rules of engagement have changed after the 1996 and the 2000 pact. The soldiers were asked to not use firearms 2 kilometers from the line of actual control. Now, that has changed. The commanders can sanction the use of firearms, and you have Beijing now wanting to talk.
Well, it has to be said that the previous meeting that took place at the Major General's level, there were 2 points that were made. Perhaps that would have made a significant difference, because this meeting today's was being negotiated for a while. And those 2 points were simple. The fact that, yes, you can come in, but if you come in, the point two, you will incur casualties. There will be a cost. If you come in, you will not come in freely. And if you come in, you will incur casualties. That was the point that was made at the Major General's level when Major General Bapat and his equivalent met several days ago. And that point is perhaps crucial, because the Chinese know now, first of all, they don't have to be told this, and they now know that, yes, if they enter again, it will not be a free-for-all. It will not be, India will not just sit tight, number one, and two, once they enter, they will enter and pay a price for it.
All right.